Hey, this is Tony, and this video is from my mom who wanted to see kind of what we're up to with RC cars these days. Let's see, starting over here, we've got some classic goldpan RC 10 electric buggies here. This was one I got a long time ago from a friend. It was a conversion to a truck, but it was really difficult to get the correct size rims for it in that upgrade, and so I converted it back to a buggy. And so it's, you know, the pan's a little bit warped, but this is a good one just for thrashing and, you know, running around. Now this is the next one that's almost a classic restoration. Pretty good condition, pan's in pretty decent condition. You see a lot of original parts there. And then I have my old RC10 GT, which I just started the roller right now, but in pretty pristine condition. Little bit slight discoloration and rust there that I've been working on by putting some WD-40 to kind of work on that out, but it's in decent condition. The engine that I got probably 15 years ago with that car went through a lot of hardship trying to get it tuned right. I didn't really know much about them, so it was my trial and error, and just recently failed. But there's a good way to get those engines restored by using WD-40, letting it sit, and using a combination of that and simple green degreaser is what I used, and the thing was running pretty good. But I kind of pushed it too far without breaking it in while trying to tune it, and that one ended up blowing up on me. So the next is this one here. I think this is a GT3 or GT4 blue pan. This is in good condition. I got this one used. The engine was frozen. I applied the same techniques and got that running. So that one's ready to go. That one is ready to run. However, the bell and the shoes inside that bell, the standard GT RC10 GT shoes, are horrible at. You either have to cut them down and sacrifice your engagement, or how quickly it engages, or the thing just won't idle properly. I mean, I had the engine pretty sweet, and it kept rolling forward. And I'm like, well, I don't really like that. So I'm gonna upgrade to the MIP. I think it's a 3012 clutch shoes. It's an upgrade. And this is the one we got for Daniel. It was on sale. It's a nice little cheapy electric four-wheel drive. A Truggy, and it's got a stock motor, a lot of stock parts there that look pretty good right out of the box. We were having some trouble with the servo, so we upgraded to a Metal Gear servo, and even upgraded the horn to a aluminum horn. So we get pretty good turning radius out of that thing, and good torque. It's decent on the accuracy, it's not bad. So this seems to work well for Daniel. Finally, we're gonna move towards this bad boy, this ofna 8th scale. Everything else over there was 10th scale. This is 8th scale. This thing's a monster. This thing, now that I know how to tune the engine, I'll be starting this one up probably today and see about getting this working. It's pretty monster. It's got some good parts there, as you can see. Two-speed transmission, four-wheel drive buggy, and looks like it's ready for some serious driving there. Look at that. And so that's that. I have a pretty decent little working on my organizing my parts. I got bags of unopened stuff as well. Here's an extra. These Metal Gear servos, the one I have in the Razor, the Raz-R, is a MG. Let's see if you could see it. MG996R. It's not bad for an inexpensive Metal Gear high torque servo, decent speed. But in the ofna, I just got a new Hitec 645MG Metal Gear servo. There was something a little bit more serious for this car. So we got some pretty decent equipment in here, and hopefully we get anyhow, this is what we got, and next clip will be showing some runtime.
On your marks, get set, go.
Ready?